professors. I just drove here from Portland because I'm an idiot. I think the hardest thing is the breakup, you know, when you've been driving next to someone for 2 hours and then you cross ways. Then Honda and I were fucking tight. My family's here. They sprung my dad out of the hospital early. I was like, don't worry, Dad, I'm not ready to tell dead dad jokes yet. And my brother Phil's here from Spain. Boy, did he waste this trip. It's fine. I've done some competitions before. Actually, the first year I did stand-up, I got into the finals of the comedy competition they have in Billings. It's garbage. Don't go. I got my ballots back from my prelim round because I kicked ass, and they wrote, chicks aren't funny. Chicks aren't funny. And then they crossed it out and wrote, you're the exception. Like, I see where that was supposed to be a compliment. Thank you for hearing my jokes over the roar of my fucking vagina. You're trying so hard. I mean, whose dick do I gotta suck to get some gender equality around here? Get workman's comp for cock jaw?
Oh, I'm not proud of that one either.
I do consider myself a bit of a sexual predator. That's mainly okay because of how non-threatening I look. I get it. I look for the cutest and the weakest gazelle in the bar. I was at the VFW and I told that joke and a guy yelled, I'm broken feet! He wasn't cute. Clearly, two criteria. I set the bar unbelievably low. I have to, like, worry about you and want to look at your face. Like, that's like, no. But being a sexual predator, I've realized I don't want kids. Give it up for no babies. No babies.
Flush a fucking pad.
So I come home from work the next day, there's white fluff. dead.